20th of March, the 9th Armored Division made a final assault on the West Wall. The Americans approached warily, expecting the pillboxes to explode with fire. There was none. The pillboxes were empty. Most of the defenders had gone. Some remained at their posts and surrendered. Others fled under cover of darkness. A few ransacked the ruins of houses for clothes, assumed civilian guise, and kept on running. Once the Allied forces were across the Rhine, it was only a matter of time before the Third Reich collapsed. This did not prevent the Germans from fighting on, and another 2 months passed after the crossing of the Rhine at Remagen before their surrender on the 7th of May 1945. By then, the West Wall had played its part in deciding the new shape of Europe and the nature of post-war politics, for the way in which it was finally overcome did not arise from purely military considerations. The Low Countries and northern Germany had come under Montgomery's overall command, so that taking this route to invade the Third Reich, as envisaged before D-Day, would have brought American forces under British control. However, the American generals were too chauvinistic to stand for that. This applied particularly to General Patton, whose name for Montgomery was unprintable, and to a lesser extent to General Bradley. To Patton, the idea that his hated rival might be the first to reach the Rhine was anathema. As for General Bradley, he had his own secret agenda in February 1945, when he suggested that Hodge's 1st Army and Patton's 3rd Army should mass at the Rhine to cover Montgomery's narrow front thrust across the river. This was important insurance against the Germans staging another Ardennes-style offensive. But it was no coincidence that it also made sure that the Rhine crossing would be an all-American enterprise. General Patton had made his own contribution to this state of affairs. By turning his aggressive defense at the West Wall into an aggressive offense, he drew the focus of American operations southwards. This was the wrong position for a speedy drive to Berlin, and meanwhile the Russians gained the time to move in from the east and reach the German capital first. Subsequently, this enabled them to claim for communism a larger share of Europe than the British and the Americans meant them to have. And for the next 45 years, until communism collapsed in Europe and the Cold War came to an end, the world had to live with the consequences.